Local geology near and around Kalamazoo is a tribute to the massive glaciers that once covered much of Michigan. The surface in the area is mostly comprised of quaternary glacial outwash. During part of the 2.6 million year long time we call the quaternary period that continues to present day, glaciers carved into the Michigan basin. These giant masses created large moraines, which are masses of sediments and rocks deposited by a glacier in U-shaped valleys. Then the glaciers traveled to the north, leaving their work of scattered rubble and boulders behind. Features left by the glaciers can be seen nearly everywhere along their paths. One notable example of glacial outwash in Michigan is the Kalamazoo Ravine's Road Gravel Pit. Today we are going to walk through the gravel pit and explain the geological principles that were required to build up this mound of entirely different sized rocks and sediments. How do we know this outcrop was created by a glacier? What happened during the most recent ice age in the Pleistocene epoch? What is the geologic history of the gravel pit, and what can it tell us about the most extensive outwash plain in Michigan? To begin, the Riverine Rubbed Gravel Pit likely formed during the last major glaciation in Michigan. This glaciation was during the Pleistocene epoch, which spanned from about 2.58 million years ago to 11,700 years ago, and represents the middle of the Quaternary period. More specifically, these glaciations occurred during the end of the Pleistocene in what is known as the Wisconsin stage, taking place from 70,000 to 8,000 years ago. The low temperatures of the Wisconsin stage prompted the formation and periodic expansion of the Laurentide ice sheet, which formed around 50,000 years ago. In this stage, ice sheets covered much of what is now Canada, spreading into Michigan, Wisconsin, Iowa, and South Dakota. The sheet, at its largest, lowered the Earth's crust by 300 meters and reduced global sea level by 40 to 50 meters. It changed air circulation, eroded the surface, and deposited material further south. But this glaciation was not continuous throughout time and had periods of expansion and contraction before starting to disappear around 13,000 years ago. By 8,000 years ago, much of the Laurentide ice sheet was gone. Glacier disappearance drastically changed the groundwater of North America as they melted away. Substantial amounts of meltwater penetrated the ground up to 1 kilometer down and traveled up to 110 kilometers away. This massive influx of fresh water changed regional flow patterns and recharged aquifers that had been isolated for millions of years. But the final years of the glaciers in the area saw more than just a change in groundwater. As the glaciers retreated, spruce trees, grasses, and sedges that mammoths and mastodons relied on were replaced by deciduous trees. This increased the mammoths and mastodons' competition and signs of stress, which is suggested to contribute to their eventual extinction in North America around 13,000 to 10,000 years ago, though early human hunting or an extraterrestrial impact may have also affected them. So what caused the glaciers to form and then just melt away? The current cause of the glaciation is still debated, but it is suggested to be part of a recurring series of colder climates that result in glaciation and may include other minor fluxes in temperature. One hypothesis proposes the causes of this periodic change in temperature could be due to the variations in solar output, as marked by changes in tree rings, although the scientific community is still investigating other possible causes for the glaciation. Some research suggests the Laurentide ice sheet retreat was sudden, as the glacier began breaking off into the ocean and retreating northward, but the current research is limited by age constraints. Now that we know the history of the Laurentide ice sheet and why it may have formed, we can look at the geologic characterization of the Riverine Road gravel pit. The Michigan Department of Natural Resources has previously mapped the area. When looking over the map, you can see the different moraines that were formed during the time of the Laurentide ice sheet. Previous research into this ice sheet divided the moraines into two sections. For this video, we will focus on the Lake Michigan lobe of the Kalamazoo morainic system. In the Lake Michigan lobe, the ice sheet left behind several geological formations and moraine deposits. Glaciers traveled down through the northeast into the Kalamazoo area. However, eventually they began to melt and retreated north. As the glaciers retreated, they left behind the Kalamazoo moraine, which is represented by the darker green color on the map. This deposit is comprised of a poorly sorted mix of sediments from silt to boulders. They also left behind the lighter green till, which forms a ridge hill marked in light green on the map. Following that, much of the floodplains came later, and the one we are most interested in is the light pink at this location. The gravel pit now marked on the map is comprised of the Galesburg and Vicksburg Outwash Plain, which is a mix of boulders and gravel. This would have been formed by a retreating melting glacier that deposited a range of sediments behind. This is what now comprises our gravel pit, a gentle slope down from the moraine comprised of sand, silt, and gravel, which occasionally has some small faults. The rest of this map is from later small glaciation events that repeated through the area. Other outwash deposits overlaid the area as well as small lakes that would have been filled with glacial meltwater. The area is a testament to the repeated glaciation events that Michigan underwent during the Quaternary period, and the outwash deposits from the Kalamazoo Moranic system are the most extensive outwash deposits in Michigan. With our knowledge about the history of Kalamazoo and the surrounding area, we head over to the gravel pit and get a closer look for information. We can see the effect of glaciers in this outcrop. Note the major cliff in the gravel pit surrounded by significant amounts of rubble, all varying in size. The composition ranges from sand to large boulders. Moving such large pieces takes a lot of energy, and therefore the presence of larger grains tells us this gravel pit was not created by a gentle river. A quiet river would be too low in energy to move the large grains found here. The large variation in sediment sizes here suggests glaciation, because glaciers are able to simply pick up any loose sediment from small sand to large boulders. With that knowledge, it can be assumed that this gravel pit is what would be left at the edge of a glacier. There are also horizontal layers within the gravel pit, which are seen as different stripes of color. This lateral change would have been caused by repeated cycles of deposition over time. Within the layers, there are larger sediments near the bottom of each layer and smaller sediments near the top. This is called fining upwards, and suggests as each layer was deposited, the energy decreased, resulting in smaller and smaller sediments being deposited. The fining upwards tells us this gravel was deposited in cycles, with periods of large amounts of meltwater that left behind the gravel. Following this came periods of lighter meltwater that deposited the sands and silts. This cycle and the flat plain that is now interrupted by mining is how we know the gravel pit is part of the outwash plain, and not the moraine itself, which is further to the north. Of course, the outwash plain is much larger than the gravel pit, as it extends much further south and east outward. Michigan's largest outwash plain was formed during the last major ice age. Due to currently unknown causes, the Laurentide Ice Sheet formed around 50,000 years ago, extending into the Michigan Basin. This formed the moraines, but also the large outwash plain that can be found in Kalamazoo's local gravel pit, and with it, the layers of geologic cycles and history. Time and warmer temperatures saw the departure of the Laurentide Ice Sheet, but here we still have a local reminder of Michigan's largest outwash plain.